Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be ways that you can be savvy with money whilst you're at university. So in my last video I did 10 ways to make money at uni, and I'll just put it there in the card so you can watch that after you watch this video. But today I just thought, yeah, why don't we talk about how you can save your money and how you can use it well whilst you're at uni and maximise what you do have. So if you want to see that, then just keep watching. Okay, so my first tip is about textbooks, and that is that you do not need to buy them from the university bookshop. They are astronomically expensive, and more often than not, you can get them from your university library. So check your reading list, check the library, get them out before anyone else does, and then just keep renewing them if you can, if they're not asked for by anyone else. But even if they are, if you're in a university city that has more than one uni, then, and you know someone at the other uni, you can just ask them to check their library, because even though they do similar courses, they might use different textbooks and they might have the textbook that you need, but people won't obviously go or think to go to the other uni. So just have a look there. That's what I did in my final year. Managed to get a book for the whole year without having to hand it back, so that was really helpful for me. Okay, so my second tip is to shop smart. What I mean by this is, obviously most people know once you're at uni, you need to start shopping at Aldi and Lidl. But on top of that, shop smart. So don't shop when you're hungry, because literally everything you see, you'll just end up putting it in your basket. And that's just not helpful when you get to the till and you realise you spent £60 when your budget was 15. So just be careful with that. Also, I'd say shop in the evenings, because often there'll be stuff that is coming close to their best before date and the shop can't resell it, but it's still safe to eat and often just freeze. So if you buy it in the evenings, you can get a lot of discounts. So shop in the evenings, shop when you're full, and shop at Aldi and Lidl is my tip for doing your grocery shopping. So my next tip is actually, I probably should have put it at the start, but it's to make a budget and stick to it. So there's so many resources that you can use online. There's templates in Microsoft Excel, or even in, if you go on Apple, on, I think it's called Numbers, that you can use, that I've been using. There's also YouTube videos if you don't know how to make a budget or where to start. All you need to do is like put the income that you've got, and then put categories in terms of your expenditure. So whether that's transport, groceries, rent, food shopping, clothes shopping, entertainment, all that, put them in sections. And just update with your transactions each time you spend money, so you know how much you've got and how much you've got left to spend for the month. And that way you should keep yourself comfortable and not go off track. Also, it's just a helpful like resource to know how much you're spending, because often you think you're not spending that much money and then you see your budget and you're like, whoa, why did I spend so much on Mackies? My next tip is to open a bank account with perks. So when you come to university, there are a lot of banks that do student accounts. So they give you interest-free overdrafts up to a certain amount. I think Santander, the one that I had, gives you up to £2,000. Now, whilst I'd recommend that you go into your overdraft if you can avoid it, I know that at certain points it's difficult not to, and if you don't have money to pay your rent and you need to go into your overdraft, then just make sure you have an interest-free paying overdraft. That will help you a lot. Also, with some of these banks, they offer extra perks, like if you sign up, you can get £100, or you can get a rail card that lasts the duration of your degree, or 4 years, whatever is shorter, longer, 4 years, I think. Anyway, just 4 years. And that is so helpful, because that gets you a third off all rail fares within the UK. So it's definitely useful to get your hands on that if you can. So that's with Santander. But I'll leave a link to Money Supermarket where you can you can compare the rates that they give you for different student banks, and that'll help you a lot. Okay, if you haven't heard of Challenger banks, these are banks like Monzo, Revolut, Starling, and they basically are just run on apps, and these are really good also for budgeting, because it kind of does it for you. So instead of typing in all your transactions into an Excel spreadsheet or writing it down by hand, these place your expenses into categories for you, so you can see how much you've spent at any given time. So these are really helpful, because you can put caps on like what you want to spend, and then it will do that for you. Also, these banks, if you want to, for example, save for something and you want to round up your expenses, so say you paid for a coffee £2.40, I don't know how much coffee costs, I'm not a coffee drinker, but let's say it was £2.40, it would round up to £3 and put 60p into a pot or a vault, and this money can just like rise up and rise up. That sounds so aff. This money could just be put into like a pot, and it can just increase, and you can use it for whatever, but it's just a way to save as well, and just round up your expenses to the nearest pound. So that's been helpful. Maybe you can treat yourself at the end, or put it into investments, or just save it for if you want to go on holiday, or just anything like that. So those are really helpful, and I'll leave some links for those banks in the description box. Okay, so my next tip is regards to clothes. I think it is very useful if you are friends with the people that you live with and you're around about the same size, share your clothes, because especially if, for example, you want to go out, you can automatically triple, quadruple your wardrobe just by sharing clothes, and it just helps so much. Just a quick one, but it's just a way so you don't have to keep spending money. And if you guys like the same things, if you have the same fashion sense, then share, you know, sharing is caring. Okay, so walking is your best friend whilst you're at uni. It saves you so much money, and even though it might take a little bit longer, it's better for your health, it's better for your wealth. It's just the best thing to do, to be honest. Most people walk to uni, so if you're in your first year, try and have proximity to uni as one of your requirements for where you stay. Because if you can walk to uni, it just saves you so much hassle than getting a bus pass. And even if you do get a bus pass and you're able to use your student discount, do it if you have to, but I would always just suggest walking everywhere. If you like to online shop, please use Top Cashback. It is such an easy site to use, and it basically gives you cash back on all your shopping that you might do, whether that's clothes shopping, sometimes food shops, electrical items, traveling, utilities. You can get cash back on a lot of things. Sometimes it takes a while to get it back, and it's often maybe only 1 or 2%, but this adds up. So I've currently got, let's see, so far I've currently got £261.28 of cash back since I started, and I started using this site a few years ago now. I can't remember exactly when, but you can see like, and I didn't do anything necessarily to deserve it or whatever. I didn't spend any more than I was already intentionally spending. So it's just a way for you to get cash back. And I'll leave a link to my referral code, and you can get £5 when you do your first shop with them. But it's just an easy way. It's literally, you go through the site first and you just shop as you would have shopped before anyway. So save yourself some money and download Top Cashback. The next thing I kind of already alluded to earlier with the bus pass is use your student discount. Now, as well as using your student card that you should get when you first come to uni, you can also download Uni Days, Student Beans, Totem. I think for Totem you have to pay, but it's still worth it because it gives you some extra discounts on things that you might not get with Uni Days, like Transport, National Express, and Megabus. So I would recommend having them all. Most of them are just apps, so you don't actually have to have a physical card with you at all times. But yeah, literally I think discounts are made for students, so if you can always carry a student card around with you, you'll be in with some deals. Just everywhere you go, ask if they do student discounts, even if you're not sure. It's just better to ask than to go away without having your discount that you could have had if you just asked. So even though I would recommend to everyone to join societies, they can be very expensive, and you can rack up hundreds and hundreds of pounds without you even realising. So I would just be careful on how many you join, because each one has a joining fee. And if you join sports clubs, you have to pay for the, what's it called? Outfit? Uniform? Sports kit? That's it. Sports kit. That you play in. You also have to pay per match. You also have to pay if you want to join into socials, then you'll have to pay for that. So there's just a lot of expenses that are attached to societies that you might not actually think about. So whilst I do encourage everyone to join societies because you can make friends and all that. Just be careful on, you don't have, if you don't want to go to every single social, you don't have to go. And don't make anyone feel like you have to go. Don't let anyone force you. Just be stubborn on the things you say yes to, because if it's not in your budget, it gets to go. Just on that, actually, let's say you guys wanted to go for a meal, you and your friends wanted to go for a meal, but why not just cook? Buy the ingredients from Aldi, Lidl, or maybe even spice up and go to Tesco and just cook yourself a nice meal at home, because you'll save so much more money and you can have just a nice time in your own house without having to spend money going outside. My next tip is to do with transport and traveling home. So a lot of people in the UK tend to go to different cities in the country when they go to uni. So if you are considering doing that and you need to get home, why don't you try using Megabus or National Express instead of going on the train? Now, yes, it's a little bit less comfortable, and yes, it might take a little bit longer than the train does, but you can save so much money by taking the coach over the train, even with your rail card. I'd still recommend having a rail card, because for short journeys it is worth it, but for longer journeys I would say that the coach is always the better option if you can deal with the less comfort, I guess. Okay, so the next thing you have to download when you come to university is the app Splitwise. So this is an app that basically helps you split your costs between maybe your flatmates or your friends. So if someone, for example, bought toilet roll for the flat, but you didn't want to ask someone for 20p each, it's just a way that it will accumulate the money that people owe you, and then you can sort out, I don't know, every month, every week, and pay each other back rather than you having to chase up everyone. It's just an easier way to put it into the app, and then everyone can pay you back like that. If you like to go out, I would say do not take your card with you, but just take cash so that you don't end up spending your whole life away. Another app I'd recommend is called Too Good To Go. Now, this app is to do with food, and basically a lot of different companies and restaurants, when they're running out and they're about to close, they often have a lot of food left. So this is kind of to avoid food wastage. So they'll sell what they've got left for cheaper. And it's just a good way to, one, help the environment because there's less waste, and two, grab yourself a deal. If you can wait long enough, you can get a deal, maybe like £2 for a whole meal. I know some supermarkets do these magic boxes. So it's like you can get loads of random stock for like £3. So it's a really good app to download and you can save some money. The next thing is cooking. So if you make a food timetable, if you don't mind the structure of that, then you can use that to generate the food list that you need to go to the grocery store. And this will help you save money as well, because it means you don't have to eat out all the time, you don't have to buy lunch every day just because you forgot and you woke up at 8:45 when you're 9 a.m. You can just grab something out of the fridge and go, instead of having to rely on food places that are often more expensive on campus because they know people need it. So yeah, just if you can be pre-prepared and cook your own food, it will help. You can make a batch and put some stuff in the freezer. I usually cook on Sundays for the week, and then just, I don't mind eating like a lot of the same food, to be honest. So, but if you like the variety, then you can cook like a meal for the evening and then have your leftovers for lunch or that kind of thing. But you can work out something that works for you. But I would just say, try and avoid eating out all the time. It would be nice to have like it as a treat every so often, but if you're eating it out every day, it kind of diminishes its value, in my opinion. But yeah, you can save so much money by cooking. Just learn to cook, get a cookbook, cook together, make it fun, and save some money. So guys, we've come to the end of the video. Hope this was useful and you enjoyed it. If you've got any other tips, you can put them down in the comment section below, and you can all help each other. But thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe if you haven't already, and like this video if it was useful, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.